Earth is running out of natural resources. We are running out of resources. And researchers track this. Every year, they calculate the date in which we will use up all the resources the planet is capable of naturally renewing over the entire year. That day is referred to as Earth Overshoot Day. And this year, it falls on July 29th. That means that after 210 days into 2021, we'll be living on credit or digging into our savings to live and survive on this planet. Sounds grim? Well, it kind of is. But to further explain the calculations and importance of Earth Overshoot Day, along with what we can do about it, I spoke to Laurel Hanscom, CEO of the Global Footprint Network.
We were thinking about this in terms of your rent, for example. If we were making a certain amount of money and then paying a certain amount of rent every month, we ran out of our rent money this year on July 29th.
Earth Overshoot Day was created by the Global Footprint Network to help us reduce our pressure on the planet, and it's determined by measuring biocapacity. That's the biological capacity of the planet to regenerate natural resources and absorb waste materials. A great, yet super depressing example of this is how parts of the Amazon rainforest are now emitting more carbon into the atmosphere than they are sequestering. The Global Footprint Network then takes a biocapacity number and divides it by the humankind's ecological footprint, then multiplies that number by 365 to determine Earth's overshoot day. Now, I know it all sounds very technical, and don't worry, not asking you to do math. You can actually visit the Global Footprint Network website to see the exact breakdown. To better understand biocapacity, ecological footprint, and solutions, it helps to think about it in these five pillars.
The first is planet, how well we're taking care of our planet and for other species and biocapacity and biodiversity. Second is energy. Where does our energy come from? Is it coming from clean sources or dirty sources? Third is cities. How our cities are made and the infrastructure and policies that are pushed through are hugely important in determining how efficient we are in using resources. The fourth is food. Where we get our food, how we eat it, how much of it is consumed, the agricultural processes we use, including regenerative agriculture, all contribute to it. And finally, how many of us there are on the planet. The more people we are on the planet, the less resources there are for each of us.
The Global Footprint Network has recorded this day since the 1960s, but according to its calculations, Earth has been in overshoot since the early 70s. Back in 1970, Earth's overshoot day was on December 30th. Since then, the date has moved up progressively, now landing in July. That's a little over halfway through the year. Last year, because of all the lockdowns, the day landed on August 22nd. So it moved back a month, which is good. But like Laurel says, do we want solutions to come from disaster or design?
So not an ideal situation for moving back the date. In fact, it was based out of tragedy and disaster rather than design and ingenuity. What we really want to see is being able to move the date of Earth Overshoot Day to December 31st and beyond, but because we decided to, not because we have been forced to through disasters like pandemics or other results of global warming, climate change, desertification, acidification, etc.
It's important to note that each country also has its own overshoot day, which is an overshoot date in the entire global population consumed in the same way as the profiled country. The United States had its overshoot day back on March 14th, so that's how bad we're doing. Indonesia, on the other hand, their overshoot day is December 18th. The goal for Global Footprint Network is to move the date to December 31st, meaning we go a full year without exhausting our natural resources. Although it seems like a massive undertaking, they were trying to spread awareness and hope by educating people and also using the hashtag #MoveTheDate on social media. It's clear that governments and corporations have a lot of change to enact within their own businesses. Things like implementing better policy around protecting land, using clean technology, and supporting sustainability within our own food supply chains. However, there are still things that you can do as an individual.
But some of the biggest ones are about making changes, not just at in your household, but in your community. And asking more of our decision makers, whether those are decision makers that are at, you know, at your company, at your city level, at the state level, and really pressuring them to start changing policy in a way that supports thriving within the means of our planet.
At the end of the day, moving the date is something that affects us all.
Ultimately, at the end of the day, sustainability is a social justice issue. If we're not thinking about how we're going to feed and clothe and power, you know, the humanity then we are reinforcing the exploitation of our land and of our people. And so the importance of this comes down to not just making decisions at every level, but to caring for our fellow human beings.